Some time ago, I had the opportunity to interview Sean Carroll. At that time, he was at Caltech, professor of physics, and he had written a book called Something Deeply Hidden, or something like that, in which he proposed a multiverse theory based on quantum physics. In fact, he suggested that there were infinite universes and different dimensions of space-time. I became very intrigued with his idea and started to explore the idea of multiverse and infinite universes, and found that actually this is one of the most common interpretations of quantum physics, more than the Copenhagen interpretation. It is right now the multiverse or infinite universe theory in quantum physics is the most widely accepted theory. I didn't know that, but this is what I discovered. At the same time, I was very familiar with Tibetan Buddhism and some of the Hindu scriptures and Vedic scriptures, and a phrase from the great yoga Vashishta, yogi Vashishta, where he says, infinite universes come and go in the vast expanse of consciousness, like motes of dust shining in a beam of light. So I started to explore the parallels between the quantum multiverse and the spiritual multiverse. Let me share this with you. The multiverse theory in quantum physics and the ancient spiritual traditions both offer intriguing perspectives on the nature of reality, though they approach the concept from different angles. The multiverse theory in modern physics, based on string theory and quantum mechanics, proposes the existence of an infinite number of parallel universes with varying physical laws and also varying physical properties. This mathematical model suggests that for every possible outcome of a quantum event, a new universe is created, leading to a vast landscape of universes. While this theory remains speculative and difficult to test experimentally, it provides a framework for understanding the immense diversity of possible universes that could exist. Now, in contrast, ancient spiritual traditions, both Hinduism, Vedanta, and Tibetan Buddhism, describe a multiverse of Lokas, Lokas. Incidentally, Loka, it seems to etymologically be connected to location. So once again, in contrast, ancient spiritual traditions like Hinduism, Tibetan Buddhism, Vedanta describe a multiverse of lokas or realms of consciousness, where each loka represents a distinct frequency domain or plane of existence. These traditions view the material universe as a dream or a projection of consciousness, with the lokas being akin to different levels of this dream. Okay, so different levels of this dream. Cosmic consciousness is dreaming universes into existence. From this perspective, the diversity of universe is not a mathematical possibility, but a manifestation of the infinite expressions of consciousness. Since consciousness is infinite, its manifestations inevitably have to be infinite. While these two perspectives may seem disparate, they're not necessarily mutually exclusive. It is possible that the mathematical multiverse theory and the spiritual multiverse of consciousness could both hold truth, representing different aspects of a deeper, more fundamental reality. The quantum multiverse may be the mathematical expression of the spiritual multiverse, with the branches of the wave function corresponding to the different lokas or planes of consciousness. Ultimately, both the scientific and spiritual perspective offer valuable insights into the nature of reality and the possibility of multiple interconnected universes. By considering these different viewpoints, we may gain a more holistic understanding of the vast and mysterious cosmos in which we find ourselves. Now, the mathematical description of multiverses doesn't allow us to explore these experientially. But the consciousness version does. By shifting to different planes of consciousness, we can find ourselves in these different lokas or universes. So if you read the Tibetan Book of the Dead, if you read some of the ancient scriptures, then shifting states of consciousness allow us to explore different realms of existence. I would love to know your feedback. Which one of these are true? Are they both true? Is the mathematical version, the quantum version of multiverse, after all, is computed in consciousness. Even the theory is in consciousness, the math is in consciousness, and scientific, quantum mechanics is a model in consciousness. So is consciousness projecting infinite universes? And if we have access to this consciousness, can we experientially explore infinite universes? Let me know what you think. You might think this is all so crazy and off the wall, but you know what? I enjoy sharing it with you. Take care and lots of love.